What is up? It has been a minute since I have uploaded a video. I have been very, very busy in the edit here. I got so caught up in the last days of filming and then immediately went into the edit and sound design. I am still heavy, heavy, heavy into the edit. I'm actually on my third pass of the entire film. Normally what I do is I go scene for scene and I just work a scene, work a scene, work a scene. And I always say that I kind of treat it like video games where like I get to a point to where I just don't feel like I'm making any good progress anymore. And so I'll move on to another scene. So I always start off by working each scene as individual pieces. You know, when you're playing a video game and you get stuck on a level, if you get up, turn it off, walk away, go do something else later when you come back to it, for some reason it's just the easiest thing in some cases to beat that impossible level. Kind of helps me compartmentalize. And then kind of the second pass through, I start to work on blocks of scenes where I'm starting to color the scenes in similar fashion, similar form. If I'm using LUTs, I'm going to start using the same LUTs or close to the same LUTs as far as the color palette for the film. So after the first pass, we were at about 2 hours and 36 to 2 hours, 40 minutes, somewhere around there. Basically what I had to do was look for areas to trim it down, but then also still allow the film to breathe. It's kind of funny because nowadays everybody puts everything into YouTube terms where you want like all these quick, fast cuts and short movies. In this sense, this is a traditional film, so you want this thing to actually have life and character and breathe and not be too fast-paced. And I'm constantly being critical of, okay, I just had three really short scenes back-to-back-to-back. Is that too short for those? Is it pacing too fast right there? I didn't necessarily have it planned to be that length in accordance to the script. The script was, you know, really about an hour and 30, hour and 40 minutes. But again, we had so many changes and just things worked out differently. And that's kind of a lesson there that goes along with being a resource filmmaker, you know, having to create stuff on the fly and deal with what you have to deal with. the filming process is great, and it, all the experiences are something that I'll definitely be able to take on and apply to other projects and hopefully other films in the future. But editing is just me, you know. I don't have to worry about anybody else showing up or people not showing up or, you know, good friends flaking or anything like that. I simply just have to get up in the morning, come to the computer, and then just start grinding away. There are like a lot of little details. There are little weird things that I do in the edit. I'm not gonna say necessarily everybody out there does these or pays that much attention to detail, but especially because this is such a like a no budget resource made movie, you know, you're kind of the underdog, so you want to improve everywhere that you can. Currently on the third pass, we are at 1 hour and 49 minutes, so we're getting there. There were scenes that were cut. That's really a good thing in my case. There were professional actors and non-actors that were just helping us. So in that case, I'm able to find areas that are the strongest for people to leave in the movie and then chop the rest, as long as it keeps the story. So I have some room there to work with. So I'm very, very fortunate that we did end up with a little bit more footage. Just been grinding away. On top of that, we've had holidays, and Ellie had her first Thanksgiving. It's crazy living through holidays now with a kid, creating this movie with a kid. You know, she's been here in the editing room with me, and just kind of, she loves screens and looking at screens, so she's just kind of looking around at everything. I plan to just edit as hardcore as possible in the week of Christmas. I'm not going to turn on the machines at all. I'm not going to edit a single bit. I may take some video and maybe put some YouTube content out of holiday happenings, but I'm not going to touch the movie at all. And then start of the year, I'm going to kind of go through and review it again, and if anything needs to be polished up, then I'm going to polish it. But we should be fairly close to finished, if not already. There are details that you can miss. You know, you get so wrapped up and you get so close to something, you're staring at these screens all day. Maybe that's my takeaway for today for anybody out there that's interested. And anything creative, really, make sure you take a break. You know, give your brain a rest, because you want to make sure that you're still creating and you're not just getting absorbed in a work type environment, right? You know, you're gonna miss some of the character, you're gonna miss details, you're gonna miss small dumb stuff. You know, you want to avoid that. So give yourself some time off. You may feel guilty about it, especially with something like this. I've got a lot of people that are wrapped up and that have helped out and that are really eager to see this, but at the same time, you got to take care of yourself. You need to make sure that you're mentally fresh enough to get into this thing to make it the best thing possible. It could be painting, it could be drawing, it could be sketching. That's it for today. I'm getting back into the edit, and I will see you guys soon.